Just a couple words about strategy and why things in family law, why I push to certain things in family law I do. I've been doing this for 30 years. And in 30 years, I found there are some statistical anomalies in family law that are easy to figure out and easy to follow. Like, if you're in possession of the child, there's a 96% chance you're going to walk out of the court with a child in your possession. So if you go to court with a kid in your possession, you don't lose the kid in the fight at the courthouse. Most of the time the child stays with you. Because the reason this is so high isn't because the courts aren't looking to, they favor one side or the other. They say, oh, you got the kid, you win. But they kind of do. Because what they say is they look at the standards of the situation and they go, I have a duty here and a temporary order, because typically the first time you go to court is a temporary order case, right? What are judges trying to do in a temporary order? What did they always say? It's a band-aid, right? It's not there to have crazy turnarounds. It's not there to have startling outcomes. They always say that's for the final trial. We'll wait for that final trial to do that. But here, we're just going to maintain the status quo. It's triage. We're going to just let's just make sure the child's protected, make sure they have a safe place, make sure it's a standard that we can hold that just needs some stability. We're going to imply stability. So you better, if you go into that first hearing, be in a position where that you want to be in, and you want to be in for a long time. So if you don't have that child in your possession, you better get the child in your possession. This is, everybody knows this. That's why there's so much pre-hearing obtaining the child, you know, like through emergency orders that are done before temporary orders hearings. They go in, get the kid in their possession. Now the kid's in their possession. You go into TO, what's the judge do? He does the status quo. He maintains the status quo. He protects everything. They just won the case because you'll never have a final trial. Almost, there's only like 1% of cases ever make it to final trial. All of them get settled in mediation, and they wind up with the kid in the position that they're in at the temporary order hearing, like something happened there, and it didn't. It's just the way it is. But the court doesn't go in, and their standards are right. Some judges know this better than others, but the courts don't. Their duty there is to maintain the status quo so that you can move on down the road and have your trial someday. The problem is you never have your trial because you get the mediation, and the mediators talk you into doing pretty much what you did at the TO hearing. Because the statistics support that too. So it's serious business in this business to go get the child in your possession before the fight even starts. So if you're thinking about a custody case, you better be talking to somebody that says, this is how we're going to go get the kid if you don't have the kid. Or tell you, hey, you better do something to protect that child because they're going to come after your kid. It's just something you got to know. It's just the aberrations, the strangest things about this business, you know. It's just the way it is. But everybody in this business has got half a brain, knows this. So I just wanted to say that, keep that in mind.